Between Mars and Jupiter, there is a large void, an area to study that astronomers enjoy. A gap with a ring made up of millions of planetoids, or also known as a belt of asteroids. Hurtling through space in their orbit round the sun, these large, irregularly shaped rocks have a lot of fun. Made up of different rocks and metals, each asteroid is unique. Let's go out and find some and see who we can meet. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet more asteroids.
I am an asteroid way out in the Kuiper Belt. My name is Albion. I was the first trans-Neptunian object discovered after Pluto and Shara. Because of how far away I am, I was found 62 years after Pluto's discovery. But now scientists have more powerful telescopes and make discoveries much more quickly.
I'm a potentially hazardous near-Earth asteroid. Mushroom is what they call me. My extremely eccentric orbit takes me close to Earth, Venus, and Mercury. I also have a small moon named Swanet, which makes it binary. I have lots more close flybys to Earth land, but I won't hit you, so don't worry!
A heavily battered and cratered asteroid in the asteroid belt. Letitia is my name. In 2010, the Rosetta spacecraft captured photos of me, increasing my fame. I'm likely a leftover fragment of the same material that formed Earth, Venus, and Mercury. I formed with the inner planets close to the sun, but was ejected by a collision, probably.
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. A collision with one is something Earth should avoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet some more asteroids.
Ganesh, an asteroid that NASA's Lucy spacecraft flew by in 2023. Lucy discovered my little moon named Salam orbiting me. But Salam is a special moon and had a surprise for Lucy to see. It has two lobes that are connected. Salam is a contact binary.
A potentially hazardous near-Earth asteroid, I gave your planet quite a fright when I passed by Earth really close in 2015 on Halloween night. I have a highly elliptical three-year orbit, but that was my closest flyby. My skull-like features are a bit scary on 2015 DB145.
They call me Lempo, or Lempo-Hisi, or even Lempo-Taha-Hisi. Why? Because I'm a trans-Neptunian triple system, or trinary. I'm Lempo, have a moon, Hisi, of almost equal size, making us binary. And orbiting us both is Taha, our moon, making us a family of three.
There are three broad composition classes of asteroids, C, S, and M types. C types are the oldest and most common, and C stands for chondrite. Made up of clay, small stones, and mineral granules, and very dark, not light. S types, or stony, are made up of mostly silicate rock materials, and much more bright. M-type asteroids, or metallic, have lots of metals in their composition. They can have nickel, iron, and some even have gold on them. The compositional differences are related to how far from the sun they formed. Some experienced much higher temperatures and partially melted and are deformed. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet some more asteroids.
Themis, one of the large asteroids in the asteroid belt and head of the Themis family. Thousands of C-type asteroids that likely came from the same collision of parent bodies. I'm also special because I have water ice on me, a real mystery. Studying me could lead to clues about Earth's origins and history.
An asteroid or a comet? That is the question. A rocky body with a comet tail? I spin rapidly and shed small dust particles behind me, leaving a smoke trail. Was I in a collision that loosened an icy crater, or am I an old comet disrupted by Jupiter's gravity? I'm Elst Bizarro from the asteroid belt, and an active asteroid is what they call me.
Named after the suave British Secret Service agent because of my number designation. I'm Asteroid 9007, but call me Bond. James Bond.
Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet the asteroids.